So that is what we have done in Ngulia, but we are aiming higher. We are developing advanced sensor technology solutions, but not in Kenya. We start here in Sweden in our offices, and we try it out at Kolmården Zoo. So Kolmården is our test site in Sweden. And as you can see behind me, there are four rhinos in the zoo. And in contrast to Ngulia, you will always see the rhinos when you come to Kolmården Zoo. And there's always a lot of action taking place here in the savanna part of the zoo. So I will show some examples of what we have done at Kolmården. And you can imagine what this will mean to the Kenya Wildlife Service once we have deployed it in Ngulia. So we have a concept called the remote watchtower. So when we first came to Ngulia and interviewed the rangers and officers and said, what do you want the most? Many of them said, a watchtower. We want to climb up over the bushes to see what happens on the longer distances. But the manual watchtower is not so much worth compared to a remote virtual watchtower, where we add a lot of sensors so the rangers can log in to the watchtower and see in real time, maybe even better than with their own eyes and ears. So we will use thermal cameras to see in complete darkness, microphone arrays to improve the hearing, and maybe a radar in the end. So here's a kind of mock-up of how such a virtual watchtower can look like, including a radar. Here's an example from Ngulia, where we used a thermal camera from FLIR to monitor an elephant. It was completely dark at this time, so it was not possible to see it. You could hear it, but I couldn't see anything that night. And the microphone array can be used for beamforming sounds. We can locate sounds and direct the cameras or other sensors to that point. So Kolmården test site has been used for many kind of sensor technologies. Let's start with camera surveillance. Let's start with the GPS trackers. So we try to put a commercial GPS tracker on the ankle of the rhino. And with that, you can follow the movements of the rhino for a couple of days. Unfortunately, the battery time is quite limited for GPS and radio transmitters. And further, unfortunately, this equipment is quite sensitive. So a few months later, we found the equipment to be broken by the rhino. Drones are fantastic for getting aerial images of the animals. And if you add a thermal camera, you can see much better where the animals are, even in dense vegetation. So here we can see overlaid thermal imagery over the video images. And maybe you can see that we have a suspicious person hiding behind a tree, almost outside the scene here. And again, the thermal camera can reveal individuals, even if they are trying to hide behind a tree, like this potential intruder to be left here. The guy is also trying to hide behind the tree, but less successful. Classification. We have ongoing research on how to automatically, from video, classify which animal it is, and maybe in the end also which individual it is, so we can monitor the status of individual rhinos, not only detecting that the rhino is close to the virtual watchtower. So regarding localization, we have worked on quite a few research projects at the Kolmården Research Arena, putting different kind of sensors on animals. Everything from seals, dolphins, snow leopard, goats, lynx, etc. besides the rhino. And as an example, we put a Bluetooth tag on the snow leopard in a necklace. And the goal for the biology student was to study how different kind of smell stimulations affected the curiosity of the snow leopard. So some smells are led to that the snow leopard came more often to just smell on this little thing. And using BLE technology, we could register how often the snow leopard came to this smell stimulation and how long it stayed. We put a similar necklace with the Bluetooth tag on the goats, all the goats in the children's zoo. And the goal here for the biology student was to study the interaction between kids coming into the enclosure and the goats. So we can measure the proximity between the Bluetooth tag and the kid that got one of our smartphones to measure the signal strength from the Bluetooth tag. We have also came close to the challenge of missing people using the drone surveillance technology we used for finding animals with Bluetooth tags. So when we have a drone flying over Kolmården, we can also detect other radio transmitters like Wi-Fi or Bluetooth equipment in the park. And so, suppose now that we have a missing people here in the forest, and that person has some kind of radio transmitter, maybe a phone without cellular connectivity, or a smartwatch or some other Bluetooth tag. So when we fly over here, we can detect the signal strength from that transmitter and in that way locate the missing person. So here's an example of a test flight with a drone over Kolmården. We actually did this patrol twice a day during the summer 2018. Just to check that it can fly autonomously in a pre-recorded way, more or less like a regular patrol. So these video images can also be used for putting together a 3D model of the area. So what you see next is a 3D model taken from this, or built from this video. So this is actually kind of virtual reality of the wildfire roller coaster. So we had student groups making scenarios for missing people, also with participants from the missing people organization. So what you will see in the next slide here is a search area. So suppose that the missing people officer has got the task to search this area. He has a search group and he has two drones to his disposal. And you can see the red aircraft, blue aircraft symbols representing the drones. And you can see light green dots representing individual search people. And the red star marker is where the hidden, the missing person is hiding in this scenario. So when we start to play here, we can see that the drones are flying around. The search patrol is moving around on random. In the back end, we can see that the search people actually come close to the missing person because they get radio detection, and we can see a signal strength indication by the circles flashing up sometimes here. The important thing is that the backend can compute a heat map of where the missing person might be. And this heat map might look like this one. So we have the darker red color, the more likely that area is for the missing person. And this was computed automatically in a few minutes after the drones fly by the first time. So this is a missing people scenario. It can, of course, also be a rhino monitoring system where we have Bluetooth beacons on the rhino and the drone is flying over Ngulia to locate every single rhino and see where they are and also maybe get some activity data from the rhino over Bluetooth to check that it is doing well. So Bluetooth and radio has a certain advantage over even over thermal camera, because what you see in the next here is the video from the thermal camera on one of the drones, and we can see warm objects as bright white. So actually you just saw a white blob passing by and that was the missing person. But if you watch this kind of video for hours, it's quite easy to miss one white blob from other white blobs. So radio is much more reliable for this application. So there's a certain link between our work in Ngulia for rhino conservation and assisting Kenya Wildlife Service rangers with technology with AgTech 2030, where the purpose is to provide Swedish farmers with technology for improved and optimized farming. So AgTech is a Vinnova-funded initiative with similar goals to Project Ngulia. And if you project Ngulia to this application, we want to help farmers to monitor the well-being of livestock using technology to assist and digitization with app and dashboard, using animal tags, etc. So a lot of similarities here. And here's a little overview of how we can bring over this technology from one domain to another domain. I will talk more about this in another lecture.